F500's improvement. Four.
Six gassers ready to go. The race. racing Rodero.
We'll be in 40% every 30 miles. Rodero, top competitor, has been driving this car for over a decade. Gary Rodero behind the wheel out of Merced, California, 48 Austin to the Brad, 452. And that did not sound good.
It does.
Rodero and many of the others on the heritage train, but also were one.
Wittberg and that circuit breaker car, the Piccolo Vulture CP Corolla, that baby won road racing. That thing was all over that right lane there. Sashaying down there and Pete just staying right with it.
Onto a ferry. And bring it over to the main line.
Shut off down there, but that Sean Bowen car was gone, Donnie Couch, and then unfortunately had to pedal it and shut it off down there. Though Wachowski kept going. It off and Top Fuel has been kind of wild, Donnie.
Yeah, that was another awesome.
Yeah, 5, Tyler Hilton goes to the number one spot. 579, Pete Kaiser goes to the number two spot. Wow! Dusty Green, if that car was on a pretty good run, then you saw Donnie moving around. Tyler was pretty good also himself, and then it got over near the wall, and he went, yep, I think I'm going to lift out of the throttle. Made a move to the left, got over near the wall, and the veteran that he is went, lifted it off that
wisely, shutting it up.
But Adam up to the number three spot at five, I'm sorry, the number two spot at 575.7. Second zone.
just came out, uber late. He goes 6:13, 225.
Oh man, Steve, he was all over that center line. He was really, he was like a magnet to that thing.
He didn't knock off any of the center blocks.
Look at this one. Got a long, really quick, 7.5 seconds.
up a 10 to a 9.20 for Jerry, and he is definitely not going to improve on that. Lip, pedal, all the above. From a 752 and Jeff Cassell. At 168 for Tony. You can tell he lifted a little bit early to make sure he would not go under that 7 flat index.